In this video, I build a couple of miniature 3D printed BattleBots and make them fight.
As a kid, you've probably watched or at least heard about BattleBots, the well-known combat robot show on TV featuring a couple of weapon-equipped robots fighting till absolute destruction in a metal battle arena where sparks fly, gears grind, and every thunderous collision reverberates through your very core. If you're like me, you might have dreamt of becoming a mad scientist and building a BattleBot of your own, or even two. I'm Max, and I'm about to take you on a journey through the creation of two remarkable 3D printed mini Arduino BattleBots inspired by the same legendary TV show. So for mine, I chose to recreate Death Roll and Hydra, two BattleBots known for aggressively flipping their opponents over. One uses a deadly spinning blade and the other a mighty hydraulic flipper arm. And in this video, I challenge myself to recreate both, but miniaturized.
I started by planning out the parts I would need and how I'd position them inside each of the model BattleBots. Starting with Death Roll, I gathered the parts and modules which I already had lying around and put some of them together, forming a rough outline of the enclosure where they'll sit. After measuring each and every part that was to be a part of mini Death Roll, I took note and started designing my first BattleBot in Fusion 360, the CAD program that I use. Started from making the enclosure and modeled the components to help me with designing. Used images of the real-life Death Roll to assist me all the way through, down to the smallest detail. Gave it the crocodile head cover that holds the blade, nails for scooping other bots, and even an arm with a hunting knife like on the real BattleBot.
So now that I've finished 3D designing Death Roll in the CAD program, I can now go on to designing Hydra, the second BattleBot which Death Roll will be going up against. For this one, I'll have to do a bit more 2D sketching in advance so that I don't mess up on all the measurements of how parts are supposed to sit inside. So mapping out a little sketch from its back piece will give me a good idea of what I'll have to punch in the CAD program to get it all extruded right.
For Hydra, I started with a similar plan, but to make things sit more spread out and flat. Focused on copying every detail, but instead of hydraulics, I designed a spring-loaded mechanism with gears to cock back and trigger the arm to flip up. Then came the time to collect all the pieces which make up the robots. If only it were that easy. So I actually sliced the designs in Cura first and sent the G-code on a card for the printer to do its printing. This is Mini Death Roll's main body, and these two represent the weapon and the crocodile top cover, which the weapon spins between. After finishing up printing all the smaller functional parts, I got the wheels, flipper arm, and all the other parts printed in a bluish dark gray in just under 72 hours. Some of the fangs on the crocodile cover didn't print out right, which meant I had to go ahead and reprint them separately so I could glue them on later. Then I started printing the parts for Hydra in matte black.
You watching these build process videos is awesome, but if you want to take part in building your own BattleBot, I'm excited to tell you that I'm selling the full 3D models that I designed of these two mini BattleBots for you to print from home. Email me at maximaginationbusiness@gmail.com for more info and how to go about purchasing the designs today.
While the remaining parts for Hydra are printing, I thought I'd save time and get straight to working on planning the circuit behind both of the BattleBots with the electronics I've prepared. Knock knock, a package arrived. Sponsors at Arduino sent me their new UNO R4 WiFi microcontroller boards just for this project. Not one, but two of them for each robot. Coming all the way from Italy, the UNO R4 WiFi is the all-in-one tool for makers sporting a faster 32-bit microprocessor and an ESP32 S3 chip with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, allowing you to control projects remotely through your device. The UNO now has a built-in 12x8 LED matrix display to add a unique and creative touch to your projects. You can get your hands on one by purchasing through the link in the description below. For the BattleBots, I challenged myself to use the Arduino UNO R4 Wi-Fi as the controller. With all the electronics gathered, I could then grab a sheet of paper and draw a rough diagram to eliminate confusion at the wiring stage. So I began putting together a prototype circuit of both BattleBots, first focusing on the differentiating features of Death Roll with its brushless motor for the weapon and servo for the flipper arm. Here's where my biggest challenge came, working on coding for both robots in the Arduino IDE. I took code syntax from new Wi-Fi example codes and libraries, which I never coded with before that the Uno R4 could only work with, to establish a Wi-Fi connection. Sadly, I wasn't able to use older Wi-Fi car codes that would work on an older ESP32, so this put pressure on me to get it done by myself. But on the positive side, I managed to get it working with the Uno R4 Wi-Fi. I began creating buttons to control the robot's motors through an access point web server, made functions for a servo motor to flip the arm, and buttons for starting and stopping the brushless motor, which will have a weapon. Using Arduino's LED matrix editor, I made a happy and angry face, then converted the two into code, making the Uno R4 display them when the weapon buttons are pressed. For Hydra's circuit, I removed the servo and replaced the brushless system for a brushed one with a tiny geared motor for the robot's flipper arm. With these hardware changes, code changes also needed to be made.
With the prototype circuit all finished, fully working and programmed for it, I'm glad to say that I can now move on to wiring the finished circuit, which will sit inside Death Roll, the robot which I'll be assembling first. Oh, and if you're interested in building your own couple of BattleBots, you might consider obtaining the code. To do so, email me and I'll give you the info on how to purchase them.
Once the other few parts were printed and cleaned up, I had all of them laid out, ready for them to be worked on. Certain parts didn't come out in one print, so I had to glue those remaining pieces onto the main parts themselves. Oops, turned out Death Roll's blade was a little bit lopsided, so I fixed that by identifying where it would need a weight to balance it and added one. Then came the time for painting specific areas on these parts so they could stand out in red. Once those were painted, I could push in M3 threaded inserts where needed so things could be tightened down. The first BattleBot I chose to fill with electronics was Death Roll. As my go-to soldering iron for wiring circuits, I use the TS-101 Smart Soldering Iron from Miniware, sponsors of this video. The TS-101 is for those of you who want a quality and efficient solution to working with electronics, as it heats up in a matter of seconds, prevents fire hazard with automatic cooldown when not in use, and is made portable when hooked up to a power bank. As the saying goes, quality is more important than quantity. This soldering iron shows just that, as it's outlasted all my cheap $10 irons I used to go through. The TS-101 might just be the iron for you. Click the purchase link below to learn more. Continuing with the project, I made a quick connector for power which can be toggled on or off with the switch hidden at the back. Then I installed the two geared drive motors for the rear wheels, followed by a dual H-bridge motor driver wired to them, which I tucked down at the front of the bot. Connected up a 2-cell battery which seemed to fit perfectly between the motors. I mounted and connected a brushless electronic speed controller tucked in at the other side and measured to see it can power the Arduino with its 5-volt pin. This 9-gram servo motor I secured at the back was designed to flip the self-righting arm, but for this robot it'll only work for looks. For the Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi to fit in the robot's enclosure, I had to desolder and remove the pin headers and connectors which were in the way, making the board 4.5mm in thickness. Once I got it secured, I could then connect all the loose wires up to the corresponding output and power pins as on the diagram. I also managed to find the crocodile cover, a pair of 3mm red LEDs for the eyes. Focusing on the upper part of the BattleBot, I trimmed certain parts off an 1800kb brushless motor and glued on some small hex nuts so it could be secured. Death Roll's blade attached to the motor, I could then secure the weapon with some bolts into a rounded divot in the top cover by design. For the wheels of the robot, I chose to first improve their grip by adding on rubber rings cut from an old bicycle tube before mounting them on. To give the ability of disconnecting and taking off the top cover when needed, I soldered the brushless motor connectors back onto the loose wires and glued the LEDs in the eyes of the robot. Against dust and dirt from landing on the Arduino's display, I even gave the top cover a transparent protective screen, then secured the top cover down. To build your own BattleBot, you may check out the affiliate purchase links I've left in the description below to all of the parts used in this project. Before finishing up, painting the arm seemed like the right thing to do so it matches with the rest of the robot's features. With that mounted on, Death Roll is complete. That weapon sounded like a vacuum cleaner at only half throttle, so I went in and reprogrammed it so it spins 1/10 of its full speed, which turned out to still be powerful enough to do some damage to another BattleBot. Using similar parts and the second Arduino, I got straight to working on Hydra as the opposing BattleBot. Starting with this tiny metal geared motor, I began putting together the mechanism behind its flipper weapon. Out of these two gears I printed, one goes on the motor and the other gets turned by it to turn 360 degrees while triggering the flipper piece. And then I installed similar parts in Hydra, which also made up Death Roll. Front drive wheels seem to turn fine, which led me to installing the rear wheels that spin freely. Going back to the flipper mechanism, I used these window screen tension springs, which turned out to be the perfect candidate for the flipping weapon. I even 3D designed grooves to hold two of these in place. Once the flipper piece is slid on with the springs in the two holes, the arm could then be fastened with a couple of bolts. The first problem I encountered with the mechanism was that the flipper simply wouldn't lock down into what should be its default state due to not planning things out quite right initially. At first, I tried making a feedback loop with a button to stop it when it moves down, but that didn't work, so I dropped pursuing this solution. Not giving up, a simpler and maybe even better solution came to mind. Looking at how a zip tie works, it ties in one direction only without returning due to the tie head and notches in the cable part. Knowing this concept, I got to work redesigning Hydra's flipper weapon with the same type of notches in the tail of it. Once I got a new one printed with the changes, that meant I also had to reprint the gear which triggers the flipper with some changes as well to lock in place after one rotation. Now seeing that everything worked fine, I could charge up the robot before closing it up with its seamless cover piece. The mini Death Roll BattleBot happens to weigh in at almost 600 grams and Hydra at just 100 grams lighter.
Now that I'm at the stage of filming the battle between the two combat robots, recording decent footage for that with my phone could not possibly be smoother than with a gimbal.
I'm thrilled to introduce you to the Hohem iSteady M6 AI Smartphone Gimbal, a feature-rich image stabilizer. First up, check out its impressive 3-axis stabilization. Whether you're vlogging, filming action sequences, or showcasing your creations, this gimbal ensures silky smooth professional-grade videos. No more of those amateur handheld shaky shots. Like other phone gimbals, included are different buttons and knobs for convenient camera control, all from the grip. What I really like is that the gimbal can reverse charge charge, which means it also doubles as a power bank, recharging my phone on the go. And what I found crazy is that the batteries lasted 18 hours of runtime per charge. But one of the mind-blowing features it has that makes this gimbal stand out is the gesture-activated AI active tracker device.
Watch this.
With this little device clipped on, I can be hands-free and the gimbal follows me around like my personal cameraman.
This game-changing technology helps me focus more on what I do best, creating cool projects and bringing them to life like these epic BattleBots. So whether you're a filmmaker, smartphone enthusiast, or a YouTuber like me, the Hohem iSteady M6 is a must-have tool in your arsenal. Click the link in the description below to level up your content creation game by acquiring what could even be your new AI pal. Hey, do good by my side, but never replace me. Promise? I don't think that was a yes.
To get the BattleBots going is as simple as switching each one on and connecting your devices to their access point Wi-Fi networks. Then the control panel can be found under a specific IP address and a web browser. Now the two 3D printed mini Arduino BattleBots are ready to fight. Let the bots battle begin! Welp, Death Roll lets itself get nudged aside by Hydra, missing out on attacking.
There they go again. Like drunken fools, both bots seem like they're totally disoriented. Oh! And it nips Hydra up its rear end.
Talk about wrestling. Death Roll here getting put in a tight spot as Hydra aggressively rams up in reverse, dominating Australia.
Look at Death Roll punching its fist in the air in despair.
Uh-oh, I think Australia had enough. Hydra better dodge these swift smacks from that high-speed blade.
Reversing again, I think Hydra is trying to avoid using its flipper. Never mind. Hydra turns the tables, wedging in under Death Roll, forcefully immobilizing it.
Wham! Hydra really felt that punch, but does not back down.
Uh-oh. Hydra's flipper got stuck as Death Roll here just chips away at the flat robot.
Hydra seems to keep escaping Death Roll's mighty grip.
Look at Death Roll over there trying to immobilize Hydra while cornering it without the weapon going.
Death Roll may have managed to corner the other robot, but unfortunately, time's up.
That was the battle between the two mini BattleBots. I let you be the judge of which one actually won. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And since you watched the video till this point, you might even want to check out how I transformed a Hot Wheels car into a FPV RC micro car in the last video. I'll see you there.